shoulder to shoulder. Please fill in the gap. Eid prayers is sunnah muakkada. There will be six takbiras after takbiratul ihram. And in the second rak'ah will be five takbiras after we stand up, inshallah. Straighten the lines, face the qibla, devote your prayers to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar. As many as there are pilgrims in Mecca, Allahu Akbar. As many steps are circumventing around the Kaaba, Allahu Akbar. As many stones being thrown in Jamarat, Allahu Akbar. As many hairs being shaved in this great day in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the heavens and the earth. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, taqullaha haqqa tuqatih wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Fear Allah, O you who believe, as he should be feared, and do not die except on a state of Islam. This is an important day, the day of Eid, the greatest feast of Muslims, where Muslims all over the world gather in obedience and submission to our Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, following the footsteps of our beloved prophets Ibrahim and Muhammad alayhi wa salatu wa salam, showing the whole world how Muslims are submissive to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how obedient to the commandments of our Lord. The significance of this Eid comes as its importance to sacrifice, to give, and to share. This is how this Eid came about. And if you want to really have real joy and celebration of this Eid, we have to follow what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has left for us. When he says, "Taraktu fikum amran," I have left you with two things. If you hold tight to them, you will not go astray. It is the book of Allah and the sunnah, the path, and the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this day, and when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had his final pilgrimage, Hajjat al-Wada, there was a universal proclamation of the human rights that signifies the importance of this event. The uniqueness of our religion. We know there are other religions, there are other cultures exist. But the uniqueness of our religion, that it has a mission, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God Almighty, has sent the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to complete all religions. Al-yawma atmamtu lakum dinakum. Al-yawma atmamtu lakum dinakum. وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي. Today, I have completed your religion and perfected your religion and completed my blessing upon you and have chosen for you Islam as your religion. This is the uniqueness. It came as a perfection to all religions. By the same token, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with the mission, إِنَّمَا بُعِدْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ, that I have been sent to perfect the best of manners. So the quality of Islam, the quality of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the quality of your religion that you should be proud of, it came to complete and to perfect religions and best of manners. And his proclamation in Hajjat al-Wada'a, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke of 4 points, which are relevant today and will be relevant at all times. The first of this is the sanctity of life, the sanctity of private ownership, and the sanctity of honor. This is a very important pillar that if humanity today respect and observe and follow the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we will not see all of what we are seeing today in the bloodshed that existed throughout history and nowadays. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam proclaiming, Ya ayyuhal nas, to all humanity, all people, Inna dima'akum wa amwalakum alaykum haramun ila an tabtu rabbakum, that your blood and your property are haram. You are not allowed to take it from one another until you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The sanctity of the blood, the sanctity of your property, the sanctity of your honor is as important as the sanctity of this day. كَحُرْمَةِ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا فِي شَهْرِكُمْ هَذَا فِي بَلَدِكُمْ هَذَا. The sanctity of this day and this month and in this place which the Bayt al-Haram in Mecca. This is how important the sanctity of life and how important the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam drawing the attention to all humans, all humanity. He didn't speak to Muslims, say, Ya ayyuhal nas, all humans. And if we look throughout history, we see Muslims have been suffering because of this bloodshed in all places. In Palestine, and in Afghanistan, and in Iraq, and in Bosnia, and in Chechnya, and in Burma, and most recently, our hearts are feeling the pain of our Muslims in Syria and how much they are suffering of the bloodshed, of the nonsense killing of innocent men and women. There's no sanctity to life, to children, to elderly. This is happening in masses of thousands and 10,000 of innocent humans. Their blood has been shed in Syria and in Burma as late as this morning. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give Muslims strength and show them the straight path to stand up against this and to proclaim the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to all humanity, that our lives are sacred, our properties are sacred, and our honor is sacred as well. The second proclamation of a human right is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than 1400 years spoke about, is to stand up against discrimination. All aspects of discrimination, whether it's religious or social or economical or tribal, you name it. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam made it clear, and in the hadith these are the actions of Jahiliyyah, the actions of the time of ignorance that preceded the time of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَلَا وَإِنَّ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ مِنْ أَمْرِ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ تَحْتَ خَدَمَيَّ مَوْضُوعٍ. Everything, all matters from Jahiliyyah, from the time of ignorance, are under my feet. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a humiliation of these practices. The bloodshed that existed has to go away. دِمَاءُ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ مَوْضُوعًا. And he started, وَإِنَّ أَوَّلَ دَمٍ أَرَى مِنْ دِمَاءِ لَا Rabi' ibn al-Harith, the first blood that he will forgive and he will put under his feet is the blood of Ibn Rabi' ibn al-Harith, one of the people of Quraysh. Not only that, but also economic equity. A lot of what we see today is happening because of the greed. And the essence of the greed that exists today is usually the riba. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this hadith, وَأَوَّلُ رِبَا أَضَعْ عِلْمَ الْعَبَّاسِ فَإِنَّهُ مُضُوعُ كُلُّهُ. He forgave the riba of Abbas. So no more bloodshed, no more usury. So people can live in peace. There is no wealthy people will suck the blood of the innocent, the blood of hard-working men and women like you, because they have to pay usury and they have to pay so-called nice interest nowadays. These are very important pillars which will bring social justice, which will bring peace to society and prevent a lot of bloodshed that may have existed throughout history because of the greed. The third proclamation of a human rights that the Prophet spoke about in Hajjat al-Wada is to take care of women, and he specifically pointed out women because of their important role. And hunna awanun lakum, women are your partners and your helpers. Astawsu bin nisa'i khayra. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam proclaims, to take care of women, whether they are your mothers, because we know that paradise flows under the feet of mothers. Whether they are your wives, hunna libasun lakum wa antum libasun lahun. They are your apparel and you are their apparel, and you are apparel to them. Whether they are your daughters, because daughters will shield you from the hellfire, will protect you from the hellfire if you take a proper care of raising your children and your daughters specifically. And whether they are your sisters, because the mu'minuna wal mu'minat ba'dhum awliya'u ba'd, the believers, men and women, they are allied to one another. They are helpers of one another. They join good and forbid evil. And the last proclamation of human rights the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke about in Hajjat al-Wada, which is very relevant and very important as the other three, is the unity of Ummah. And we have to be careful about this. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, As-shaytan gave up, Satan gave up to be worshipped by those who prefer prayers. He has no hope for you to worship him. That is the shaytan. But he has big hopes and a lot of achievements of causing trouble, at-tahrish bainahum, in causing conflict and enmity among believers. This is where Shaytan succeeded. This is where Satan succeeded, is to create enmity and deviation among Muslims. Whether we're talking about Muslim at the level of the statehood, Muslim states, they are divided, they are in conflict, they might be in fight, or Muslim society, or Muslim organization and groups, as close as here in Canada. And that's why we should have a mission, and we should have a goal to unite as one Ummah. Because if you want to defeat Satan, this is how we can defeat it. Satan has no hope for us to pray for him or to worship him. So let's work together. We have very clear prescription from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you want to fulfill the mission why Muslims are here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. And I have created men and jinn, humans and jinns, for only one purpose. For only one purpose, to worship me. This is your mission, all Muslims, if you don't know it yet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this very single, clear mission. If you want to be saved at the personal level, if you want humanity to be saved, if you want your community to be saved, follow this, go towards this mission. Have goals to fulfill the proper worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is very clear and very simple. Our religion is very simple, very perfect. We have what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, two things, the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, there has come to you from Allah, from Almighty, a light and a clear book. يَهْدِي بِهِ اللَّهُ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ رِضْوَانَهُ سُبُلَ السَّلَامِ وَيُخْرِجُهُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَيَهْدِيهِمْ إِلَى صِرَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. What are the quality of this light and this book? As the Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, by which Allah guides those who pursue His pleasure to the ways of peace and brings them out of darkness into the light by His permission and guides them to a straight path. You have the light, you have the clear book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you, that can guide you to straight path, that can take you from darkness to light. What are you waiting for? My dear brothers and sisters, your mission is clear. Your guidance is perfected for you and protected for you to follow. It's only up to you if you want to do it or not. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم أن الله وأنتم ممكنون للإجابة. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. My dear brothers and sisters, one last point before we wrap up this ceremony. Again, this is a very important occasion. Shows the sacrifice, shows the commitment to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there are so many things in Islam we can do. But please have your mission clear, that you're here created to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one very important and very simple thing we can do, Muslims here that is gathered under this roof, is to follow the mission of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said, that I have been sent to fulfill the best of manners. One of the matters that Islam stresses, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stresses, is cleanliness. We are the ummah of tahur tahara. Well, al-tahur shatr al-iman. That cleanliness is half of iman. So there is no excuse for us Muslims. It's part of our iman to be clean, to be orderly, to be neat. And we are in this public place, everybody is looking at us. And as every camera is shooting at us, we have to show people who the Muslims are, in their conduct, in their cleanliness, in their orderly, in their meekness, in their passion. When we bring our children to line up for the ride, we have to be patient. We have to have compassion. We have to care about the youngster. And we have to be courteous to each other. If you don't practice Islam at this level, my dear brothers and sisters, we are missing a lot. This is very important and very simple ethics. Islam is a comprehensive set of rules of rituals and of ethics. And they're very easy to follow and do. And there will be a great reward. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Imatatul Adha and Tariq is part of the science of iman, musha'ab al-iman, that you remove a dirt from the street. This is how our religion is so practical. It touches each and everyone's life. If you see any dirt in front of you while we're gathered here in masses, pick it up. Show how Muslims are clean. Show how Muslims are care about their iman and their image. And how we are a good role model for humanity. If the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not the right role model for his companions, nobody would have followed him. The first thing, you have to be the right role model. So people would believe that you are really truthful to your message. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us truthful to our message. Make us truthful to our iman. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات يا الله، والمؤمنين والمؤمنات، الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك يا ربنا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تلطف بحال إخواننا المستضعفين، اللهم اطلب بحال إخواننا في سوريا وفي بورما وفي فلسطين وفي كل بقعة من بقاع الأرض يا رب العالمين. اللهم أرهم الحق حقا وارزقهم اتباعه، وأرهم الباطل باطلا وارزقهم اجتنابه. اللهم يسر لهم من أمرهم رشدا، واحقن دماءهم، واهلك عدوهم وعدوك يا قوي يا جبار يا متين. نسألك يا قوي يا عزيز أن نجعلك في نحور الظالمين، ونعوذ بك من شرورهم. احفظ يا ربي إخواننا وأخواتنا وأمهاتنا وأطفالنا من بين أيديهم ومن خلفهم وعن أيمانهم وعن شمائلهم، ونعوذ بعظمة وجهك أن يغتالوا من تحتهم. أو الله forgive all our sins. أو الله strengthen us in iman. أو الله save the blood of those who are killed innocently. أو الله protect them. أو الله destroy those who are trying to kill innocents and make them the innocents victorious and make Islam victorious and make us a peace-loving community that will spread peace and will spread belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and support the weak and support our ummah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. The next coming 3 days or after this day are the days of Tashreeq. You are not allowed to fast. You can have your qurbani until the 13th of the Hijjah after 3 days. تقبل الله منكم وعيدكم مبارك إن شاء الله. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Down the aisles all around. We cannot have this event without your donations. It is the day of Eid. Please reach into your pockets, donate generously, inshallah, so that we can continue to have these events. The next Eid Salah will be in 25 minutes at 10 minutes after 11. That's why we're going to handle that as well. And the 2 month prayer will be at 1:05 p.m. That will be the time of the event. Thank you.